In this video, you're going to learn how to transform your Canva designs into highly engaging and memorable videos using audio. Audio has the ability to connect with people at an emotional level. And as you know, emotions sell. So whether you're designing a video ad, an instructional video, or even a presentation, include some carefully selected music or even a quick voiceover so that you can connect with your audience and achieve your business goals. I'll also be sharing some very important information with you, which you must be aware of. And I can't stress that enough if you want to avoid damaging content ID claims. Plus, you'll learn how to use a new Canva feature which has just been released. We've got a lot to cover, so let's make a start. You're going to start off by selecting videos in the top banner and then selecting whichever video template you want to use. For now, I'm going to select this video template because it suits YouTube. And that will open up a blank template in my design editor. So from here, you can either start designing your own template from scratch, or you can use one of the templates in the Canva library by selecting design and then scrolling down and finding whichever template you want to start using. If you forget to start with a video template and you find yourself midway through designing one of your best projects ever, don't worry, because it's now possible to turn most Canva templates into a video. All you need to do in order to turn a template into a video is go down to the bottom of your screen and click on this teeny tiny arrow here to show all the pages of your template. Clicking on that will reveal the page thumbnails underneath. Now, the most important thing you need to do next is click on duration. And that will turn your template into a video. So you can see here we have the video play button and the video playhead. So now you know how to convert an ordinary template into a video template. Okay, so let's assume that I've just finished my project. I've created a 3-page travel agency ad, as you can see here, and I have forgotten to create it in a video template. So I'm not going to panic, because what I'm going to do, as I've shown you, is go down to the foot of my page, click on this tiny upward arrow to show all pages. There are my thumbnail images of each page. And now all I need to do is click on duration, and I've converted my template into a video. There's the play button, and here's my video playhead. Fantastic. Before I download the template, I really want to conjure up memories of happy, warm, relaxing summer vacation memories. And so I'm going to do that by adding some relevant music. The first option is to access Canva's audio library from the sidebar. So I'm going to go across to the left-hand side and find the audio tab. Click on it to open up Canva's library of audio files. You'll find music tracks and sound effects in the Canva library for both free and pro accounts. And I'll show you how to filter these out in just a second. At the top of the audio library column here, you'll find clickable tabs, which will help you find a suitable audio track. You can also scroll down the column and browse the various categories. To open up an entire category, just click on See All. The audio tracks with a crown next to them indicate that they are premium audio tracks. And you'll find the duration of an audio track right here. So this track is 2 minutes and 33 seconds in duration. If you want to save yourself a bit of time, you can use the search bar to search for a particular type of audio track. So let me type in summer, and I've got some suggestions here. Summer vibes, fun summer house. So for now, I'm going to click on summer vibes. Next to the search bar, you'll find a filter tool. So click on that and you can filter out the type of audio you want. So vocals, instruments, sound effects, free or pro. To listen to a snippet from the audio file, hover your cursor over the little thumbnail image and click on the play button. Once you've found an audio track that you like, ensure the playhead in the video editor is at the position where you want the audio track to begin. And then select Summer Vibe. And you can see here that my audio track has been added underneath my video thumbnails. You don't have to use any of the audio soundtracks at all from the Canva library because you can upload your own music or sound effects. To do that, you're going to upload it in exactly the same way as you would do a photo or a video, for example. So go to the far left-hand side, click on Uploads, and upload your file using this purple button here. You can also upload an audio file from Google Drive, Instagram, Dropbox. Once uploaded, you'll find the audio track under the Audio tab here. Once you have your audio file added to the video timeline, you can now go ahead and explore all the fabulous tools available in Canva's video editor. It doesn't matter what kind of audio file you add to the timeline, they can be edited in exactly the same way. So let's start off with some basic editing techniques. To crop an audio file in the video editor, hover your cursor over one of the sidebars and you can see that it turns into an arrow shape. Hold your cursor down and drag it along the video timeline. So you can select where you want an audio track to start and finish. If you want to use a certain portion of the audio file, double click on the audio timeline and drag the audiogram along the timeline until you find the portion that you want. Selecting an audio file will bring up a small menu of tools in the top left-hand corner of your Canva toolbar. So you have audio effects. Use this to fade a track in or out, and this is measured in seconds. So I'm going to type in 1 second here to fade it in and 1 second to fade it out. Okay, next to audio effects, you've got adjust, and that does exactly the same thing as I've just shown you. You can select whichever portion of the audio you want to use in your video. Beat sync, that's an exciting tool. So by toggling this button to the on position, each page of your template will change in time with the music beat. And you'll see the little beat markers, these little white markers, just here on the audio track. For now, I'm just going to toggle that to the off position. Click on the speaker icon to adjust the volume of your audio track. And you can now turn the volume right up to a maximum level. Or you can turn it right down or mute it completely. I think for now, I'm going to set it at 50. Now, you've probably noticed that there are three little dots at the end of the audio track. If I click on them, that'll bring up a further menu of editing tools. So I can click to copy, paste, duplicate the track, or delete it. I've got exactly the same tools in the Canva toolbar, which I've just shown you. But I can also split the audio track using this little tool here. So let's assume I need to split my audio track at the 5 second mark. All I need to do is grab the video playhead with my cursor and drag it into position, so 5 seconds into my video. Okay, I'm going to make sure the audio track is selected. Next, all I need to do is right click and then select split audio. And now I have two portions of my audio track. Now here's one of the huge benefits of using a video file when adding audio to a template, because you now have the option to add multiple audio tracks to a template. So you can get really creative by mixing music with sound effects or even adding a voiceover. And this is the perfect choice for you if you're creating, say, a video ad or an explainer video. You can add a voiceover to a video in two ways. You can either record your voice separately using your smartphone and a voice recording app, and then use the upload button to upload the voice file into Canva and dragging it onto the video timeline, as I've just shown you. Or you can record your voice directly in Canva. And this would be my choice because it is so easy. So you're going to go back to the left-hand side toolbar and click on Uploads. And underneath the purple Upload Files button, you'll notice a button that says Record Yourself. So you're going to click on that. And as you can see, that opens up a little recording studio. If you don't want to appear on camera yourself, you can turn this off by going to the top right-hand corner of your screen and clicking on the camera icon. As you can see, at the moment I'm being recorded using my FaceTime camera, so I can now switch that off by selecting No Camera. And that leaves my profile photo or logo on the screen instead. But don't worry, because we can get rid of that completely in just a minute. Don't forget to connect your microphone by clicking on this downward arrow here. So you can select whichever microphone you want to use. You can use an external microphone like I'm doing here. So I'm going to select that one. Make sure you have the slide on which you want to record your voice selected. You can do that by clicking on the little thumbnail image. And when you're ready to record your voice, just click on Record. Book now to enjoy your indulgent holiday in 2024. So to end the recording, you can just see I clicked on Done. Now all that's left to do is click on Save and Exit in the very top right-hand corner of your screen. And that will save your recording under the Videos tab. And you can see here it's just been uploaded here. So I'm going to select the page that I recorded over. Let me just minimise that for a second. The voiceover actually appears as a video overlay over the top of my page. So if I click on the play button, to enjoy your indulgent holiday in 2024. Okay, so I'm sure a lot of you will just want the voice rather than the video. So here's what you can do, and this is a new Canva feature alert. With the video overlay selected, you're going to click on these three little dots, and that brings up a whole menu of editing tools. Right down towards the bottom, you'll see a tool that says Extract Audio, and you're going to click on that. And you'll see that my voiceover appears underneath on the video timeline. So now what you can do is select the video portion and just delete it. And you're left with just the voiceover. So you can really have a huge amount of fun now by mixing music with sound effects and even adding a little voiceover to your template. And here is my completed Indulgent Holidays video ad. Now to enjoy your indulgent holiday in 2024. And now for that important information about avoiding content ID claims. If you have a free Canva account and you want to add a premium audio track to your template, you must first purchase a single-use license. You'll obtain a single-use license by purchasing the premium element before downloading it or sharing it on social media. If you'd rather share your template directly to social media, you'll need to ensure that your social media account is synced with Canva. After that time, you can select your social media platform, the file type, add a caption in the space provided, and then click the purple button to pay for the premium element and publish to social media. Since I've got a Canva Pro account, I don't need to purchase any premium elements. However, I still need to connect my social media accounts if I want to use a premium audio file in any templates. So if I want to share this particular template to YouTube, I need to make sure that my YouTube account is connected with Canva before downloading it. I know it sounds a little complicated, but I promise you, once you've gone through this a couple of times, it really does make sense. Please do take the time to read Canva's articles about single-use licenses by clicking on the links which I'll leave underneath this video. Meantime, if you're interested in learning more about Canva's video editor, check out this video, which is coming up in just a second, which will show you how to add text overlay to a video in Canva. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.